The human fall tears us apart. The Holy Marriage Blessing mends the tear.
You're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, the radio ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston.
And I'm your host, Tyler Hendricks, here with our co-host, Pastor Ruth Muanda. We're so grateful that you could join us today. Thank you for listening. Because this is a topic that actually affects everyone in the world, and that is mending the tear. Mending the tear of the fall. What happened? What was torn apart in the fall? Do you think that God, our heavenly parent, our creator, created human beings to live alienated lives, to be alienated from him, to be alienated from each other? Not at all. God is love. Trees are not alienated from birds. Birds are not alienated from worms. Worms are not alienated from the earth. Everything is harmonized. Everything is put together. It's not torn apart. And yet, human beings, it's only human beings that are torn apart, our mind and our body, our relations as husband and wife, as parents and children, torn apart, nation against nation, torn apart. God did not intend for this kind of separation, this division, this conflict situation to take place at all. It came about because of the fall. It's exactly because we separated from God in the fall, because we chose the wrong way. Human beings have freedom. We have responsibility. The R word is responsibility. It rhymes with freedom, because without responsibility, we have no freedom. But with responsibility, we have total, complete freedom, freedom to love. What is our responsibility? It's the same responsibility that God gave to the first parents, to Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. And it is, don't eat the fruit. Do not eat the fruit of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, which represents love. There's no other fruit that Adam and Eve would want to eat. They were not hungry for physical food. They were not hungry for power or for fame or for glory or something like that. They were hungry for love. The fruit of love is what they ate. The fruit that God told them, don't eat the fruit of love until you become mature, until you are ready to digest it, to digest love. And they fell, they ate it prematurely, they loved each other prematurely, and they could not digest love. They couldn't handle it. And it separated them from God. It separated them from each other. And within themselves, even, it separated their mind and body. They became ashamed. Where did shame come from? It came from the fall. God did not create us to be ashamed. And yet, because they felt ashamed. Ashamed of what? Of their own body. That means their mind and their body were separated. They said, where does this body come from? I don't like this body. I've got to hide it. I don't want people to see it. It means I don't want to look at it myself. That's a very deep, deep revelation of what happened in the fall. And what did they cover? What didn't they want to look at? Their lower parts. It's because that's the part of their body with which they sinned. So this was the tear. We've got to mend this tear. The good news is that the true parents have come. Reverend and Mrs. Sun Myung Moon, Dr. Sun Myung Moon, Dr. Hak Jahan Moon, our true father, our true mother have come, called by Jesus, led by the Holy Spirit, and Bible-based, called to be bridegroom and bride, called to be parents to the human race, called to be the true Adam and true Eve who can bring true life to all humanity, and that we can all become true parents. We can all become true husbands and wives. We can all eat that fruit. As it is mature, we can become mature, and the fruit can mature, and we can enjoy the sweetness thereof forever and for eternity. And the tear will be mended. The division will be over, the conflicts will cease, because we will find peace within. The key to peace, mending the tear and bringing about true marriages through the Holy Marriage Blessing. So I want to invite our co-host, Pastor Ruth, to share with us her prayer, her heartfelt prayer to God to be present with us in this radio broadcast. Please listen to the prayer, Pastor Ruth.
Let us pray. Our dear most and beloved loving heavenly parent, true parents of heaven and earth and humankind, and our beloved Lord Jesus, we come before you deeply humbled in our hearts and with hearts full of gratitude and thanksgiving unto you for giving us this new day where we can come into your presence to worship, to praise, and also to glorify your name. Father, for the countless blessings that you shower onto us, beginning with the gift of life, good health, and more, Heavenly Father, by you giving us your word, which, Father, recreates us, which gives us life, which teaches us about your love, your will, and your heart. That, Father, we lost at the time of the fall in the Garden of Eden. Today you want us to reconnect once again with you by understanding your heart and your will. That, Father, we can be able to grow to become your true children, your incarnation, your bodies, that, Father, you can be able to experience joy. So we are so grateful for this time, and that, Father, we pray that through the words that we are going to share this morning, that, Father, can be able to build our hearts. Therefore, we empty ourselves to you, that, Father, you can be able to fill us with your Spirit, teaching us your ways, teaching us, Father, that today you have sent us the Lord of the Second Advent, who comes as to mend us physically and spiritually on the foundation that was laid by our Lord Jesus, shedding his own blood, Father, on the cross, because at that time we could not understand our Lord Jesus. But today, Father, you give us yet another chance. That, Father, for those who are willing to give up their lives, that, Father, they can be able to be recreated. They can be able to receive rebirth, spiritually and physically, cutting us from that bondage of Satan that separated us from us and connecting us to your true love, life, and lineage. And that we can grow to become your children, who can be able to resonate with you and with your heart. And that, Father, by us resonating with you, we can be able to bring you joy. This was your purpose of creation, and it remains until today. And therefore, we want to thank you so much for never giving hope on us, for never losing faith on us. And therefore, Father, we pray that also we can be able to abide with you and live by your words and grow to become children who can give you joy. Thank you so much, Father, for this time. We invite your Spirit, the Spirit of our true parents and our Lord Jesus, to guide us through this morning worship. And I pray all this humbly in the name of the Lord. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Ruth. You're listening to the Holy Marriage Blessing radio ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. We meet every Saturday, 5 p.m. at the church at 205 Route 28. We gather there for fellowship,
singing, sharing in God's Word, and sharing our own hearts, back and forth, testimonies about how God is working in our lives, how God is working through our families, and giving guidance and mutual mentoring. The elders of the younger, the youngers of the elder, we are all learning, growing together. So our theme this week, mending the tear. So the human fall tore apart human beings. Actually, in the Bible, you know, the Jewish, Christian, Muslim traditions recognize that there was one man and one woman at the beginning, and that God implanted his and her spirit, for they were male and female in the image of God. So the true masculinity of God was implanted into Adam. The true femininity of God was implanted into Eve as his helper, as his wife, as his helper. But the Bible says that God is your helper. So God was present in Eve, just as God was present in Adam. But they were little children. They were born the same way as you and me. And they had to go through a growing period, just like you and me. So God's spirit, God's heart, God's love matured in Adam and Eve and went through the stages of growth. As the transcendent God designed and guided and set the rules and the laws for everything, Adam and Eve were created as the spark, with the spark, the divine spark within them, with God's presence within them, of purity, of pure love. But they had to grow, and they had responsibility. And the first responsibility was to be fruitful, Genesis 1:28. It means to become ripe. You know, the second is multiply. Be fruitful means a tree. It means a ripe tree. Multiply means an orchard, okay? So be fruitful and multiply are not two different, are two different things. They're not the same thing. To be fruitful means to become a fruitful tree, bearing fruit, the fruit of righteousness, the fruit of true love, to become a true man, a true woman, with your mind and your body, your spirit and your flesh completely united as one. And what would tempt Adam and Eve to disobey God? God gave them the rules of engagement, the rules of the road, so that they could be like him and become able to love like God loves, freely love, not just because they're programmed to love like a robot, not just because it's instinctive to love like an animal, but that they decide to love. Not just they decide once and forever, and they decide every moment. It's a living water to decide what course to take to live for the sake of others. That was their responsibility. And in order to fulfill that responsibility, God gave them a commandment: do not eat the fruit. It means do not engage in the final stage, the final ultimate act of love, which is that between man and woman as husband and wife, until you become fruitful, until you are truly mature, until your mind and your body, your spirit and your flesh are completely one with your Father God, completely one with your Mother God. Then, when Adam and Eve unite together, Father and Mother God are uniting together. The heavens and the earth are uniting together. The animals, the insects, the plants, the stars, the light and the dark, the up and the down, the waters below, the waters above, everything is uniting together. Everything is making one harmonious whole in which the living God's spirit and flesh are dwelling. God never wanted to be invisible. God would become visible in Adam and Eve as man and woman, creating what? More children of God. And yet this was all torn apart. It was torn apart by the fall when they became selfish, when they became greedy. Their growing period stopped when they turned inward and they decided that they would just seek their own happiness centered on themselves. And it began with the serpent, with Lucifer. It's all about me. It's not about God. God didn't take care of me. I'm going to take care of myself. And then Lucifer seduced Eve, seduced her into becoming a selfish being who thought that she would gain all knowledge by uniting with Lucifer, and that was a lie. And what she gained was all shame, all guilt, all fear, all ignorance. And then she went to Adam in that state. And then Adam fell as well with Eve, immature, unprepared, irresponsible. They became split personalities. Adam's mind and body, divorced. Eve's mind and body, divorced. Adam and Eve, they were together, but in their hearts, they were divorced. The first couple was a dysfunctional dad, dysfunctional mom, and they created children, and we know what happened in that family. So we've got split, a torn apart human race ever since. And now Pastor Ruth is going to share with us more about True Father's teachings on this subject, on the meaning and what happened in the fall. Pastor Ruth.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hendricks. And now we're going to turn to our readings from our True Father. And the topic is the internal meaning of sin and the human fall. And I read, The fall began from a motivation denying the lineage. Therefore, people have inherited the consequences of the fall as the original sin until the present day. Eve became one with the archangel through an illicit sexual relationship, and then Adam united with Eve, who had been one with the archangel. Consequently, Adam and Eve had a conjugal relationship and formed a family centered on the archangel instead of God. As a result, all humanity, as descendants of Adam and Eve, came to inherit the lineage of Satan. Adam and Eve should have united, centered on God. However, they united with the archangel, a servant of God. That is what the fall refers to. Human beings who should have inherited the lineage of God inherited the lineage of the servant instead. That is why fallen people may call God Father, but they do not actually feel that He is their Father. This is because they have inherited the primary characteristics of fallen nature, which makes them think of everything in a self-centered manner, with no regard for God or anything else. Thus, people became contradicting beings, forming tribes and nations. Therefore, these tribes and nations came to be divided very quickly. This is how the sphere of satanic culture developed. Everything that splits into two, then into three, and so forth, belongs to the satanic realm. Due to the fall, we lost true parents, true husband, and true children. Eve and the archangel caused this loss. From this viewpoint, women who live on this earth are dependent on their fathers, husband, and elder brothers who represent angelic types. The daughter of a wealthy father came to live with a man's servant. That is, her children were born into the lineage of a servant. Thus, women do not receive the love of the original husband, father, and brother. Restoration has taken 6,000 biblical years because of the complications involving lineage. Otherwise, the Almighty God would have restored everything in one day. People contracted a chronic disease that affected their lineage, so if God had tried to remove this disease at once, they would have died. That is why it took him 6,000 years. Can you say Adam and Eve fell by eating a fruit? If it were true, how simple things would be. How did the basis of sin, the fall, evil, and hell come to exist? Concrete explanation of these things is the problem. Let us go back to Adam and Eve and think about this. If we devolve into fundamental reasons of Adam and Eve's fall, we can say that first of all, they fell because of disbelief in God's commandment not to eat of the fruit of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. The second reason was their self-centeredness. And thirdly, they tried to love in a self-centered way. Since this is a core essence of the fall, we arrive at the conclusion that anyone who has same characteristics is on Satan's side. The love of fallen people is faithless and selfish. Ultimately, those who assert self-centered love are people of this world. And may God bless these words. And you're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, the ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. And let us reflect on our readings today. And from our readings, we come to learn that due to the fall of the first human ancestor, we acquired the knowledge of evil, self-centered love, selfishness, and we came to acquire split personality, where on one side we want to do good, but on the other hand, we do bad things. This knowledge of evil hurts our feelings, our conscience, and the result of it is unhappiness, guilt, pain, and suffering. On the other side, when we follow our original mind, that is, the mind of doing good, which comes from God, our parent, we love selflessly. We deny ourselves by doing something good for someone else. This gives us joy, confidence. This empowers us and keeps us with an upbeat feeling. This feeling of goodness is what God wanted us to experience for eternity. This is what we need to recreate in ourselves. It takes effort and it takes self-determination to do this. This will be able to recreate ourselves to become that image of God, to create families of God, societies for God, and ultimately the world. This begins by obeying the commandment of God and to live a righteous life. This is what becomes the fruit of goodness and denying to eat that fruit of evil by denying ourselves and doing what is righteous. This is what we are learning from our true parents, the Reverend and Dr. Sanyang Moon, called by Jesus and led by the Holy Spirit, giving us a new life through the Holy Marriage Blessing. And may God bless you and your families as we contemplate on these words.
Thank you so much, Pastor Ruth. You're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, the radio ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. Pastor Ruth talked about mending the tear. That's our topic this week. And the Holy Marriage Blessing is the process and the place that the basic tear is mended. And that Holy Marriage Blessing comes through our parents. It doesn't come from anywhere else. It comes from parents. because parents represent God. God is our Father, and also we know God is our Mother. God is our parents. We have two parents. We have a father and a mother. And we learn how to be balanced and integrated human beings by having a true love relationship with both our father and our mother. So there's a saying that every child deserves a father and a mother. And I would build upon that to state that every world deserves a father and a mother. We need the fatherly love, we need the motherly love. And true parents have come, sent from God, called by Jesus, led by the Holy Spirit, Bible-based, because the world has never had true parents. And parents are the source of government. Government is the role of the parents, the king, the queen, the administration, the president, the parliament. And if we don't have true parents, we're not going to have true government. If we don't have true government, we're not going to have true nations. They're going to fight with each other. They're going to rise and fall. They're going to ascend and they're going to collapse. And it looks like that's what we're seeing around us in the world today. We're struggling not to collapse, but there's so many signs of collapse in this world today. We need true parents. We need to mend the tear that separated us from God and from each other. And that comes through true parents. We'll talk more about this next week. We're so grateful you could listen. Our music is by Ronan Hardiman, and our feminine voice is Pastor Ruth Muanda. I'm Tyler Hendricks. This is Holy Marriage Blessing. We'll talk to you again next week.